Every day, dozens of boda-boda riders lose their motorcycles to thieves, and efforts to recover them are usually fruitless, since many of the stolen motorcycles are dismantled and sold as spares, while others are sold off in other districts. Police have, however, discovered that a number of stolen motorcycles' chassis and engine numbers are usually interfered with, making it difficult to trace them.
These motorcycles are sold as new motorcycles, and when the police engages into arresting the said persons with these new altered motorcycles, we get issues with courts of law because the registration number plate and the serial number, the engine and chassis numbers that are on the motorcycles don't coordinate with URA details. So these criminal gangs have a chance to deny that these motorcycles are not stolen until we prove that they are.
In the latest police operations, a gang of people behind the boda-boda thefts was arrested. Among the suspects is Emma Seguia, a resident of Katwe, who has made a name in erasing the original engine and chassis numbers before replacing them with fake ones.
Conducted an intelligence-led operation that led to the arrest of a criminal gang headed by one Sekamwa Suleiman Chewagana, a resident of Nabingo, who was with others identified as Kairimko. And we later on got to know that this group engages in theft of motorcycles within the country.
Upon engraving the fake chassis number, the motorcycles are sold in other districts, especially Gulu. Police say the new tactic by the criminals has frustrated police efforts to wipe out boda-boda thefts.
Suspects are arraigned in courts of law, but members of the public should know that this racket is big. We are going to continue doing these operations. We only wanted to inform you on how they do this kind of activity. I will later on take you to the motorcycle and probably demonstrate to you how they attach these numbers while using a hammer.
The suspects are currently detained at Katwe Division Police Station awaiting charging in courts of law. Rachel Nachuela reporting for the news.